Let's turn to Russia. CNN has now matched that bombshell Washington Post report that National Security Advisor Michael Flynn, according to several government officials, privately discussed U.S. sanctions against Russia with that country's ambassador right around the time that President Obama was imposing new sanctions and before President Trump took office. I guess there are two issues here. One is the White House not telling the truth about this conversation and the conversation itself. Let's take them one by one. If General Flynn did tell the Russian ambassador something along the lines of, don't worry about these sanctions President Obama's imposing, we're going to revisit them later, would that trouble you?
Well, listen, I don't think that you can have any more than one president at a time. And, you know, General Flynn has said up to this point that he had not said anything like that to the Russian ambassador. I think now he's saying that he doesn't remember whether he did or not. So that's a conversation he's going to need to have with the president and the vice president to clear that up so that the White House can make sure that they're completely accurate about what went on. But I've always been a person who believed that you have one president at a time, and that's the way things should be done.
Well, and you touched on this in your answer, because of General Flynn's original adamant denial, although as you point out, he has now walked it back saying he can't recall. Vice President Pence, Sean Spicer have now said things to the public that are apparently not true. Take a listen to Vice President Pence on January 15th.
What I can confirm, having spoken to him about it, is that those conversations that happened to occur around the time that the United States took action to expel diplomats had nothing whatsoever to do with those sanctions.
If General Flynn lied to the vice president, what should the consequences be?
Well, that would be up to the vice president and the president. And so I'm sure that there'll be conversations between the vice president, the president, and General Flynn to make sure that everybody gets the accurate story on this matter, that it's cleared up. And I think that's the obligation of General Flynn as National Security Advisor to have those type of candid conversations with the president and the vice president. And then they'll act as they see fit, given all the circumstances.